First of all, I would like to thank the organizers of this conference for inviting me to speak here today, and there are lots of support. Thank you. Today I wanted to talk about the ARC, equivalent to the blocking set, which is an interesting object in finite geometry. This is joint work with Son Ok Jung and Son Jung Kim. Let me start with the notion of a projective plane and arc. FQ, the finite field of Q element, and FQ cubed is the set of triples. Let PG2Q is the set of all triples in FQ cubed except a zero vector. Zero vector with the equivalence relation. This meaning is any vector and its multiple is the same in PG2Q. So here we called PG2Q is called the projective plane of FQ, and then we can easily compute the number of the points in PG2Q. It is q cubed minus 1 over q minus 1, then which is q squared plus q plus 1. And we consider the linear equation ax plus by plus c equals 0, which corresponds to a line in PG2Q. Simply we denote abc, only use its coefficient. Here the coefficient abc is not all 0. Then following is a known basic property in PG2Q. The total number of the points in PG2Q is q squared plus q plus 1. Sometimes we denote set at 2. And the number of lines in PG2Q is the same number. And there are q plus 1 point on a line, and there are q plus 1 lines passing through a point in PG2Q. Actually, this property is we call the duality because you change the point to line and the line on to passing through, then the statement is the same. So what is the arc? On NRQ, arc is the set of all n points of PG2Q such that some r point of K, but no r plus 1 point of them are collinear. That is, any line L meet K at the most r point, and some line meet K exactly r point. Here's a simple examples. Let's see, be a circle in PG2Q, then it note that the number of point on a circle is q plus 1. Then we can consider a line passing how to meet the circle is there is no intersection pointer, is 2 point and 1 point. So thus we can see C is a q plus 1, 2 arc. And next we can consider a line in PG2Q. Then I describe the line L0 is the blue line. And we consider the set T, the whole space, we get rid of L0. Then the remaining points, I express the yellow part. Then any line meets this L0 point, so we can count how many points, how many yellow points on this red line, then just 1 point are on the blue line, so q plus 1 minus 1, so q. And if the line is L0 itself, then there is no yellow line, so it is 0. So this set forms a q squared q arc in PG2Q. So now we define the I line. I line is a line meeting K in exactly I point. And define A sub I as the number of I points. Then we easily note that for an NRQ arc is A sub I equals 0 for I less than or equal to R plus 1. And consider the pair A0 to AR is called the spectrum of the arc K. And actually, the arc and the blocking is the same notion because the complement of arc is blocking set. The complement of the blocking set is arc. So the parameter is here. A tip for the blocking set of size M is the complement of the whole space, the total number minus this number, comma, A Q plus 1. The line has Q plus 1 point. So minus T Q arc impedance to Q. So let M sub R to Q denote the largest N for which there exists an NRQ arc for given R and Q. Actually, an interesting problem in projective geometry is determine the exact value of MR to Q. Then we can easily the trivial bound here. A point, we choose a point here. Then every line, this is including K, every line has R points. And we have Q plus 1 line passing through a point, then we can easily get this one. And for R equal 1, we note that M1 to Q is 1, and actually the arc is a singleton set. And when R equal Q, the value MQ to Q is Q squared, and which is the complement of a line. And when R equal Q plus 1, then M Q plus 1 to Q is Q squared plus Q plus 1, which is the entire projective plane. So now we consider the R is between 2 and Q minus 1. So actually, in general, Q, just a few values are known of this value. So here, when R equal 2, so M2 to Q is Q plus 1 if Q is odd, and Q plus 2 if Q is even. Actually, many of you know about this number because this one is corresponded to MDS code. And Q is prime order, then R, MR to Q is this number if R is Q plus 1 over 2 or Q plus 3 over 2. And when Q is an even case, this one is whole. It's when R is equal to this number. This table shows the values of MR to Q for Q less than or equal to 13. I think if you are looking for a new research problem, then you can find the problem here. So these red numbers shows the values of these three theorems. We got this one, the red number. The other ones is we can find this many papers. And from Q is from 3 to 9, all MR to Qs are determined, but Q is 11, is we can see just the bound. So actually this problem is was introduced by the Professor Maruta in 2007. He visited me, and then he just showed this table. So when in that time, I'm just thought, oh, why the These cases are open because Q is not so big, 11 is not so big. So I'm just thought, this case, maybe let me try in just very simply. Probably the lower bound here, then there are, they have examples 32, 4, 11 arc. But they don't know 33, 4, 11 arc or 34, 4, 11 arc. Right? 4. Yeah. So if we find an example of these two, then we can determine if we found this one, maybe we improve the bound. If we found this one, then we determined the exact value of that. So maybe we can try, because many people can, I think many researchers are good at using computers. So PG211, how many points here is Q11 square 11 plus 1? So 133. So if we choose 133 is 34, these numbers of set, then we might have this one or not. I'm not sure exactly, but look at this one. It's quite a big number. Actually, this one is finite, but I'm not sure we can do or not. But anyway, it's still open. So next, we consider the classification problem of the largest arc. So the largest arc is a Segre, 1950s. For Q is odd, every Q plus 1,2 arc is conic. And for Q is even, Q plus 2 Q arc is conic and its nucleus when Q is 2, 4, 8. But what about the Q is larger than or equal to 16? Then there are non-equivalent Q plus 2 Q arc other than conic and its nucleus. So what is a conic in PG2Q? A conic in PG2Q is a curve C with a homogeneous quadratic equation in three variables. For example, this one and this one. Actually, this one's essentially irreducible. Then we note that the number of points on the conic is Q plus 1. And for any line L, we have the following. The intersection point is 0, 1, or 2, because this is a quadratic. So a line meets C exactly one point, we call the tangent line, and two point is a two line or secant. And a line has no C point, we call the external line. And now we define a point in PG2Q is called the external point to the conic C if the point lies on two tangent line of C. And internal point, P is the internal point if P lies on no tangent line of C. And I of C denotes the set of all internal points of C, and E of C is the set of all external points of C. Then we have these numbers. So 1965, Berlotti, he gave a nice construction of the largest arc with the parameter is this one, r equal to q plus 1 over 2 and q plus 3 over 2. So for q is the other number, and then k, let k is internal set of a conic and add one point on a conic, then this set is gives this arc. And K is the internal set of a conic and union and each conic, the conic, then K forms this arc. So the following table shows the number of non-equivalent largest arc. So this the black numbers is MR2Q, and these red numbers is the number of non-equivalent largest arc. So here's also there are many open case. Yeah. So the smallest open case is Q is 7 and R equal 5. So today I wanted to talk about here, this case. So for Q equal for Q is 7, then we already know the largest number of points here like that. And when R equal 2, A 2, 7 arc is unique and it is conic, which is proved by Segre. And R equals 3, the 15, 3, 7 arc is unique. And also this is proved by these guys in 2004 in the paper here. And R equal to 4, there are 3 non-equivalent 22, 4, 7 arc. This is classified the Hill and Love in 2003. This is the paper. So now we consider this part. So I wanted to give some geometrical construction. And the case one, the K be the union of a tangent line of a conic, except tangent lines has 1 point. So we exclude this point. Then this K forms a 29, 5, 7 arc with this spectrum. So actually this case is the same as the Balotti construction. We union the tangent line except the conic point, then this one can express a conic and its internal point. Actually, a finite geometry, the picture is not exact this one because internal point is not inside this one. Outside also there are internal points, but just I draw like that. And the second case is I'm just start with the conic and its internal set. So we already knew the conic and its nucleus, its internal set is 29 points. So now I'm just remove 3 points from the conic and add 3 points in external set. Then no change the number, the total number of the points. And the lines, this is the two lines. Two lines meet like this concurrent at one this point. And then this set gives 29.5 arc with this spectrum. And the third case, the case two, I'm just get rid of 3 points on the conic, but now I just get rid of 3 points from internal set. So I get rid of this 3 points and add another 3 points in external point. And then we have the arc with the spectrum is these numbers. But case 2 and case 1, we just remove 3 point and add 3 point. So we choose a reasonable 6 point. But here's a very interesting thing. Those 6 point always forms a complete 6 to 7 arc. Here's the complete means there is no larger arc containing this 6 point. And the next 4 arcs we construct with the these 4 blank line, using these 4 blank line, which are not concurrent at a point. So we have 6 blank point, is intersection point of blank lines, and we can count the number of this the number on this line is 26. Now we choose these numbers as the complement of arc, which means the blocking set. Then now we consider PG 27. So the number of point is this one is 57. So the arc is 28. Then the blocking set is 28. So if we determine the 28 point as the complement of the arc, then the arc will be determined. So I'm just consider this 4 line, the points on this 4 line as a point in blocking set, then this is 26 point. Then we just wanted to choose another 2 point. So So we consider here's the choose 2 points and we consider the line passing through these 2 points, then except these 4 lines, then we have 3 red lines. So this one and this one and this one is 3, we have 3 intersection point of red line. Then actually 5 point on a line, that means which is the 3-fold blocking set. So a line has only at least 3 points on this line, but if we choose a line, this one, so the general line always meets these 4 points, so maybe we can compute 4 or 3. But what about these 2 lines? Then there is no 3 point on this line, this red line. So we just choose another 2 point like this. And then this red line also have 3 point. So we add these 2 points with the 4 black line, then this forms 29.57 arc with this spectrum. And the next, the same argument, we just add 2 points outside these 4 lines. So now the case 4 is we just choose 2 points among 3 intersection point of red line, but now we choose 1 intersection point of red line, and the other point is one red line. In this case, this K forms the arc with the spectrum is this number. And the next, on the same argument, we just put this 4 line And now we just get rid of one point from the one black line. Then the point will be 25. Then we want to add 3 points more. So we just add this blue point, 3 blue points we add, and then we have the arc with this spectrum. Actually, this one is a more complicated geometrical structure, but we have we consider Q is 7, then we could find this nice point. So, and here's other cases. This one also the similar way, in similar way, the former using the four line, then we could find this arc. And the other, the case 2 to 7, the other sixth case, we use the several conic and several lines. So for example, this case, I'm not sure exactly, I can't remember, but we consider the reasonable 3 conics. So we union that conic and we add the 5 point outside, like that. So those ones we use the lots of conics, the 3 conic and 4 conic and 5 conic with some points from the outside. So we could find finally we could find the 13, 29, 5, 7 arc with a different spectrum. And actually this arc, the largest arc and linear could have a good connection. So a projectable NKDQ linear code is equivalent to an N minus D Q arc. So for an NKD, N3D linear code, we have the bound. This is called the Grisma bound. So code meeting the Grisma bound, we call the length of optimal code. There are at least 13 non-equivalent 29.57 arc in PG2 7, which means that there are at least 13 29.3247 length of linear code. And if we know the 24 and Q is 7, then we just compute this number. Then this number will be 29. So we note that this is the Grisma code. So this is the length optimal code. And those are the pairs of the AIs gives the weight enumerator. So we have this length optimal code with different weight enumerators. Thank you for your attention.